Desiree Ficker is a professional triathlete from Austin, Texas, and in 2006 she placed second in the Ironman World Championship in Kona, Hawaii. We wanted to know what it was like to spend all day swimming, biking, and running. Desiree, what's it like to make a career out of doing this?
Yeah, you know, I actually have been, this is my 10th year now that I've been in the sport. It's my 7th year as a professional, and it's been a blast. I mean, it's definitely a different way to make a living. But
Desiree, tell me what it's like to do an endurance event like this. I mean, I can't imagine being out there for, you know, 9.5 hours for you, 13 hours for a sort of normal person, and a lot more for the rest of us.
It can be overwhelming if you take it in as this one big chunk, you know. So the way I look at it is I just think about the swim. And I get through each little bit of the swim, whether it's to the first buoy or, you know, then I'm going to get to the next buoy, or I'm going to just swim next to this person for 5 strokes and I'm just going to take 3 breaths and relax. So it's all about turning the race into tiny little chunks rather than one huge, massive, overwhelming entity.
It takes a lot of training to prepare for an event like this. Tell us a little bit about how many hours a week you spend doing what.
So the training can, for events like this, can take up to 25 or 30 hours a week, sometimes more, depending on if, when I'm in full Ironman training mode, let's say I'm leading up to 2 months out from Hawaii and I'm doing my biggest blocks, I can spend up to 35 hours, maybe even 40 training. So, but you know, and the thing is, the training doesn't end once you finish your run or once you get off the bike or out of the pool. It's the resting is so important also, because you know, the more time you're sleeping or on the couch with your feet up, or as opposed to out running around doing other things, the better you prepared you're going to be to go out and attack the roads the next day. So it's a constant thing, and you have to be aware of, you know, what you're putting in your body and the things you're doing outside of training at all times. So it's a full-time gig.
Desiree, what does the pain feel like, and how long does the pain last after you finally cross the finish line?
Well, your legs are very sore for 2 days, and you can often get soreness around your rib cage just because you've been breathing so hard for so long. Your neck can hurt, and you can have little chafing around your skin. I mean, it's the first 2 days are very uncomfortable. But
what do your feet look like when you're done?
Oh yeah, your feet are pretty ugly. You don't want to look at your feet too much. They're usually pretty torn up. So the feet are just done, cooked. But after 2 days, you know, you actually start to feel a lot better, and each day gets better and better. And I would say within a week, you know, after I've eaten all the food that I'm enjoying that week, I'm back to feeling fine. So you do sleep quite a bit, and you are fatigued, and you have to be really careful that you don't get sick because your immunity system is down. But I mean, it's amazing how the body is resilient and it comes back.
How your body is resilient, how your body comes back. Not sure I could say the same thing.
All right, I need to do some more abs.
Yeah, come on, Dan.
All right, I'm gonna just I'll be right with you there.